नमस्कार, आई एम वासु जैन. आई हैव सिक्योर्ड ऑल इंडिया रैंक ऑफ 67. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई लाइक टू थैंक KS जैन खान सर फॉर इन्वाइटिंग मी हियर. सो टुडे दिस वॉज माई थर्ड अटेम्प्ट एंड इन द लास्ट अटेम्प्ट आई रीच टिल इंटरव्यू स्टेज. आई कुड नॉट मेक इट दो, बट आई फील दैट वन ऑफ द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेज इन दिस होल जर्नी इज द आंसर राइटिंग स्टेज, बिकॉज यू हैव सो मेनी पेपर्स टू राइट एंड आंसर राइटिंग इज वन थिंग विच विल हेल्प यू सेल थ्रू मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स. सो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट आंसर राइटिंग. So when I'm talking about answer writing, I think there are three major things in an answer, three very important things. If I divide an answer, I see an answer from three perspectives. First is content, second is structure, and third presentation. So when I'm talking about content, content means what is the demand of the question, what knowledge you have on that particular topic. So that would be the content. And many people think that they have limited knowledge despite clearing the prelims. They don't have enough content on one particular topic. But I would say that value what you have, because it is not just about what you are presenting, but also about how you are presenting, which I will talk about structure and presentation. So content is there and that could be developed over a period of time. So one of the speaker also mentioned about watching movies. So let me tell you, in some of my answers, I gave reference to different movies. So in my answer, you will find reference to Batman, you will find reference to Harry Potter, you will find reference to various movies. So from different sources, I try to bring in content to my answer and not just from the academic resources. So this is how you can broaden your content part. Second, coming to the structure and the presentation part. So this is an area which many of the aspirants, and I also have done this mistake in the last attempt. I had not focused on structure and presentation. My sole focus was on content, how to build it, how can I read different books. But structure and presentation will make your answer different from other person. We all will be reading the same book, but how can I get one extra mark? It would be how well I articulate my answer and how well my answer is divided into different parts so that all the parts of the question are answered. And that these will be developed not in single day or 2 days, but these will be developed over a period of time when you will be start practicing. So it took me around 2 years to understand the demand of the question, to understand how can I separate different parts of the answer. And the best thing to do is you write an answer and you evaluate your own answer or compare your answer with different with others' answer. So this I used to do. There are various online free platforms wherein you can write answers. They will post daily questions. So I used to write answer there, and then I'll compare my answer with the model answer, which everyone does. From there you will get content, but you will not get structure, you will neither get presentation, because they were very verbose. So to get content, so to get structure and presentation means if there is any diagram or web chart, that way I used to go to the comment section and see others what they have written. And in that way you will be amazed to see, or when you will do it, you will be amazed to realize that they have very good answers in different capacities. You will find good structure, you will get good articulation, you will get good quotes, you will get good diagrams which you can incorporate in your own answer. And slowly and slowly, when you start including or appreciating those things will automatically start coming in your answer. And in that way, I think your answer will get beautified, or that will add value to your answer. Second thing about answer writing is practice. So many people say that start writing answers once you have good content or once you have read something. I followed a different strategy. My strategy was, if I'm reading a topic, I'll write an answer on that. Suppose if I read newspaper and there is a news on Afghanistan, I'll try to write answer on that, India's response to Afghanistan issue. So that would be my approach. I'll write answer simultaneously and think what all I can add to that. Second, within the practice thing, practice daily and practice over a period of time. So when I'm saying practice daily, practice for 2-3 questions daily. But in that, do not limit yourself to 7 minutes or 10 minutes, which is the usual constraint in answer writing. So when you're practicing daily, try to improve. And how can you improve? When you give time to your answer writing. So when I'm writing 2 answers daily, I will not look at the clock. I will rather spend 15 minutes on one particular question and try to think what all extra can I bring in. But when I'm writing a mock test for 3 hours, at that time I will be looking at the clock. So while writing 2-3 answers on daily basis, do not restrict your to time. At that particular time, your focus should be on improving your quality. adding extra things to your answer, may it be your presentation, a diagram, or say structure. Third point, that is evaluation. So when you're evaluating your answer, be brutal as you can. Because you are evaluating in person, so don't be afraid that what I have written, ki achha likha hai, nahi likha hai. Be brutal as you can. Because you are not getting judged by your answer on that particular topic. But you would be judged if you don't write good answer in the mains examination. So your purpose is to get good marks in the mains examination, not to get appreciation of others in that particular mock test. In many of my mock answer sheets, I have written to the examiner, be brutal as you can. I have directly written them. And they have been brutal to me, and that is the result I have been standing here giving a talk to you. So be brutal, be as critical as you can, just try to improve on them. Don't take the feedback in a negative way. It has given me only 60 marks, 70 marks. Don't take it negative way. I have never crossed 80 in my mock test. 80 used to be my upper limit. But when you build upon that, you can get 100, 120 in the mains examination. And the final part with respect to answer writing is the structure. Within the structure is introduction and conclusion. Try to introduce in a different manner. Not just repeat the question and conclude in a positive manner, as many others have said. So when you end it on a positive note, it shows optimism and it also shows hope in the aspirant. So many people say, if the question is critically analyzed, how can we be positive in that? You can be positive by giving a way forward, or you can be positive by showing something good which has taken place. So just try to be positive, at least in the conclusion. If not, you can't be in the whole answer. So this would be my message to the aspirants. And also I would like to give, since I have given message to the aspirants who would be watching this video, I would like to give one message to myself and to the all selected people sitting here. So we have secured this, we have secured a rank, we have got placed in the PDF, in that list, by the grace of God, by the guidance of teachers, trust of family and support of the friends. But there have been, we cannot forget the past, or we cannot forget the things which we have done. We cannot forget the hard work. And neither can we undermine the hard work of others who could not make it to the list. It was just a matter of luck, say one or two marks, by which some person could not make it to the list. But they have also worked equally hard. They have also dedicated their 3 to 4 years in this preparation, in this journey. And we cannot forget that thing. So when we have secured a good service, when we would be entering the service, we need to be respectful of the fact that it was just a matter of luck along with our hard work and the and prayers of others that we made it to the list. But we cannot be just flying very high, or we cannot be just very proud of the fact that this fact. And there are very beautiful lines in Hindi which I would like to quote. तीन चार अक्षर लगे हैं तुम्हारे नाम के आगे, तीन चार अक्षर लगे हैं तुम्हारे नाम के आगे, बट वो अक्षर तुम नहीं हो। अक्षरों की कुर्सी पर तुम बैठो जरूर, अक्षरों की कुर्सी पर तुम बैठो जरूर, पर अक्षर तुम्हारे सिर पर कभी ना बैठे। सो विद दिस आई लाइक टू कंक्लूड एंड गिव मैसेज टू द एस्पिरेंट्स एंड ऑल्सो टू माई सेल्फ एंड ऑल द अदर सेलेक्टेड कैंडिडेट्स एंड ऑल द वेरी बेस्ट। थैंक यू।